Hello viewers. In India, Social Welfare Administration is being carried out by a large number of governmental and non-governmental social welfare organizations. Social Welfare Administration brings revolutionary changes and it has to adapt change in the functioning of the government. In this lesson, we will discuss about governmental and non-governmental social welfare organizations engaged in the upliftment of society for administering the social welfare programs. The discussion will also take into account the existing and emerging problems of social welfare and development planning as well as administration of the social welfare organizations. Objectives. By the end of the lesson, you should be able to understand the concept of governmental and non-governmental social welfare organizations, understand the agencies which come under governmental and non-governmental social welfare organizations, and lastly, understand the difference between the governmental and non-governmental social welfare organizations. Now, let's look into the concept of governmental organizations. Welfare administration is an essential responsibility of government so that society remains in equilibrium. In order to achieve the aims and objectives of social welfare, governments establish organizations for the implementation of social policies and programs, and in pursuance thereof enacts social legislations, allocates financial assistance, and provides organizational and formal linkages in the form of ministries and departments. Governmental organizations. First, let us look into Central Social Welfare Board. The policy of the Government of India has been to entrust major responsibility of the welfare programs to voluntary organizations. But the voluntary organizations were not suitably equipped to execute such responsibility. Hence, the effort of voluntary organizations were isolated and uncoordinated. It was therefore considered necessary to provide with financial and technical assistance. Consequently, in the year 1953, the Central Social Welfare Board was established with an allocation of rupees 40 million as a grant in aid by a resolution of the then Ministry of Education. Composition of General Body of Central Social Welfare Board. The chairman of the board is its chief executive. As per the memorandum and articles of association, there is a provision of General Body and Executive Committee for conducting the businesses of Central Social Welfare Board. The general body is headed by the chairperson of the Central Social Welfare Board. It consists of all chairpersons of the state social welfare boards, 5 professionals, each from law, medicine, nutrition, social work, education, and social development, 3 eminent social workers, representatives of Government of India from Ministry of Women and Child Department, Rural Development, Health and Family, Welfare, Finance, Niti Aayog, etc. 2 members from Lok Sabha and 1 from Rajya Sabha, and Executive Director of Central Social Welfare Board. Executive Committee of Central Social Welfare Board. The Executive Committee headed by the Chairperson of the Central Social Welfare Board constitutes of chairpersons of 5 state social welfare boards, including 1 from the Union Territory State Board, 1 representative each from Ministry of Women and Child Development, Rural Development, Finance, Health, Family Welfare, Education, and 2 professionals from the General Body. Organizational structure of Central Social Welfare Board. In the Central Social Welfare Board, at the top, there is a General Body. Next in hierarchy is the Executive Committee for making the decisions, followed by the chairperson who administers the day-to-day affairs of the board. Immediately after chairman, there is an executive director and joint directors who act as filter and funnel to the chairman by contributing special knowledge and ability to solve problems within specific areas of operations. It also serves line agency in the matter of planning, coordination, fact finding and research. The line agencies deal with substantial fields and are responsible for implementation. National Commission for Women. The National Commission for Women Bill was passed by the Lok Sabha and the Rajya Sabha on 9th and 23rd August 1990 respectively. The bill received the assent of the President and finally was constituted on 30th January 1992 as autonomous statutory body. The nodal department of this commission is the Department of Women and Child Development. Hence, it is the apex national level organization of India with a mandate of protecting and promoting the interest of women. Organizational structure. The National Commission for Women consists of full-time chairman, 5 members and a member secretary. They are all appointed by the Government of India for a period of 3 years. National Commission for Protection of Child Rights. The National Commission for Protection of Child Rights was set up in March 2007 under the Commission for Protection of Child Rights Act 2005 and Act of Parliament December 2005. National Commission for Protection of Child Rights is a statutory body under the Commission for Protection of Child Rights Act 2005 under the administrative control of the Ministry of Women and Child Development, Government of India. The Commission's mandate is to ensure that all policies, laws, programs and administrative mechanisms are in consonance with the child rights perspective as enshrined in the Constitution of India and also the UN Convention on the Rights of the Child. The National Commission for the Protection of Child Rights emphasizes the principle of universality and inviolability of child rights and recognizes the tone of urgency in all the child related policies of the country. Compositions of the Commission. The Commission consists of the following members: a chairperson who is the person of eminence and has done an outstanding work for promoting the welfare of children, and 6 members, out of which at least 2 are women, is appointed by the central government from amongst the persons of eminence, ability, integrity, standing and experience in education, child health care, welfare or child development, juvenile justice or care for neglected or marginalized children or children with disabilities, elimination of child labor or children in distress, child psychology or sociology, and laws related to children. Administration and finance. 1. Grants by central government. The central government shall, after due appropriation made by the parliament, by law in this behalf, pay to the commission by way of grants such sums of money as the central government may think fit for being utilized for the purpose of protection of child rights. The commission may spend such sums of money as it thinks fit for performing the functions under the Commission for Protection of Child Rights Act 2005, and such sums shall be treated as expenditure payable out of the grants received from central government. Next, grants by state government. The state government shall, after due appropriation made by legislature by law, in this behalf, pay the state commission by way of grant such sums of money as the state government may think fit for being utilized for the purpose of commission for protection of child rights act 2005. The state commission may spend such sums of money as it think fit for performing the function mentioned under commissions for protection of child rights act 2005, and such sums shall be treated as expenditure payable out of grants received from the state government. Concept of non-governmental organizations. A non-governmental organization is an independent, flexible, democratic, secular, non-profit people's organization working for and or assisting in the empowerment of economic and socially marginalized groups. The right of all the citizens to form associations or unions is guaranteed by Constitution of India under Article 19(1)(c). Therefore, in India, non-profit public charitable organizations can be registered as trust, societies or private limited non-profit company under Section 25 of Indian Companies Act. National non-governmental organizations in India. Center for Health, Education, Training and Nutrition Awareness, Chetna. Chetna means awareness in several Indian languages and is a non-governmental organization based in Ahmedabad, Gujarat. It was established in the year 1984. Chetna addresses issues of women's health and development in different stages of their lives from a rights perspective. Chetna is an activity of the Nehru Foundation for Development, which is a public charitable trust registered under the Bombay Public Trust Act 1950. Chetna supports governmental and non-governmental organizations through building management capacities of educationalists, health practitioners, supervisors, managers, enabling them to implement their programs related to children, young people and women from a holistic and gender perspective, and also advocate for people-centered policies. Their core activities are capacity building, forging partnership at local, regional and national level. Chetna also develops advocacy, development and dissemination of materials. It works primarily in Gujarat and Rajasthan states. Identified as a regional resource center for Gujarat state and the union territories of Daman, Diu and Dadra Nagar Haveli to provide technical assistance to NGOs to improve reproductive and child health. Facilitate governmental and non-governmental organizations partnerships, document and disseminate successful approaches and provide inputs to the Government of India to ensure effective implementation of policies. In 2014, Chetna was designated as State Training and Resource Center for Gujarat, Daman and Diu, Dadra Nagar Haveli to support NGOs in implementing targeted intervention programs related to HIV or AIDS. YUVA, Youth for Unity and Voluntary Action. Youth for Unity and Voluntary Action, YUVA, is a non-profit development organization committed to enabling vulnerable groups to access their rights. Youth for Unity and Voluntary Action encourages the formation of people's collectives that engage in the discourse on development, thereby ensuring self-determined and sustained collective action in communities. This work is complemented with advocacy and policy recommendations. Founded in Mumbai in 1984, currently Youth for Unity and Voluntary Action operates in the states of Maharashtra, Madhya Pradesh, Odisha, Assam and New Delhi. At the community level, through an integrated 360-degree approach, Youth for Unity and Voluntary Action deliver solution on issues of housing, livelihood, environment and governance. Youth for Unity and Voluntary Action creates knowledge that enhances capacity building. Through partnerships and campaigns, Youth for Unity and Voluntary Action provides solidarity and builds strong alliance to drive change. They believe that development is a continuous struggle to create a humane society which sustains all human beings as well as nature, where women, men and children enjoy universal human rights. A human society is based on the values of equality, distributive justice and secularism, is liberated from oppression on the basis of caste, class, creed, gender, age, ethnicity and language, is free from all forms of exploitation and violence, and demonstrates integrity and respect the democratic policy and process. Youth for Unity and Voluntary Action empowers the oppressed and the marginalized by facilitating organizations and institutions towards building equal partnerships in the development process, ensuring the fulfillment of human rights to live in security, dignity and peace. It also engages in critical partnership with government and forges alliances with other actors of civil society such as people's movements, trade unions, women's group, academic institutions and private sector players to enable and strengthen the people's empowerment process. Jan Vikas, established in 1987, inspired by the ideology of Paulo Freire, Mahatma Gandhi and B.R. Ambedkar, and born out of quest for justice. With skills in behavioral sciences and human rights perspective, Jan Vikas started support to young professionals to explore arenas of social transformation. Focus, since its inception, has been on creating support system for marginalized groups struggling to lead a life of dignity and equity. It nurtures efforts at the grassroots with issues-based organizations and with development professionals. So far, it has created a web of 17 well-established national and state-level organizations. Jan Vikas has always set his eyes on creating support systems for poor, marginalized and disadvantaged communities who are seeking their right, as well as for those individuals who are seeking a more meaningful social existence. Based on this understanding, the following objectives are formed. Relating creatively with individuals, groups and state organizations to increase access to the poor, marginalized and disadvantaged communities to their legitimate rights. Fostering individual creativity along with group accountability at all levels of organization. Creating conditions for lateral linkages between organizations, giving rise to federations that can network constructively within itself as well as with external environment to change an unjust order. HelpAge India, established in 1978, the sole aim of this NGO is to provide resources to the elderly people of our country. Their objective was to make aware the senior citizens of their rights and protect the rights of the senior citizens of our country so that they can also play a key role in our society. They also work with the government, both local and national, to implement policies that will be beneficial to the senior citizens of our country. Chintan, a famous Indian NGO, Chintan, was the first in India to receive the US Innovation Award for empowerment of women and girls for its outstanding contribution in this field. The award was received by Chintan's founder, Bharati Chaturvedi, from the US Secretary of State Hillary Clinton. The award was funded by the Rockefeller Foundation through the Secretary's International Fund for Women and Girls. Pratham, the main aim of this NGO is to provide education to the children living in the slums of Mumbai and even providing education to those people who are unable to go to school. Pratham focuses on high quality, low cost and replicable interventions to address gaps in the educational system. Established in 1995 to provide education to children in the slums of Mumbai, Pratham has grown both in scope and geographical coverage. BPA, One Window Service for Persons with Disabilities. Blind People's Association is a professional organization which believes in providing equal opportunities to all category of people with disabilities. Consistent with the philosophy, it works for providing education, employment opportunities, equal rights and quality life for them. It understands that gainful employment plays an essential part in the life of a person because it gives him status and binds him to the society. Acceptance of disabled people at the work can be viewed as society's acceptance of these people without discrimination. However, many people with disabilities are still unable to obtain gainful occupation and are dependent on others. Employment and Placement Services is a step towards providing employment as well as self-employment opportunities for people with disability so that they can be financially independent and self-sufficient. Since 1984, Blind People's Association has continuously strived to provide employment opportunities to people with disabilities. During the last 5 years, it has been successful in providing employment to as many as 1500 people with disability who is presently employed in public as well as private sectors and are capable of handling important assignments in banks, railways, hospitals, restaurants, etc. They are also excellent in their work as telephone operators, computer programmers, mobile repairers, liftmen, etc. It also understands the importance of self-empowerment and provide microcredit for individuals who want to be self-employed. Under the Swayam Siddha Pariyojana project, it works especially for the empowerment of blind women by providing them microcredit so that they can be independent individuals. Blind People's Association also gives priorities to projects advocating human rights for people with disabilities. Smile Foundation. Inspired by Chenji's philosophy, a group of young corporate professionals came together in the year 2000 to set up Smile Foundation to work with grassroots initiatives for effecting positive changes in the lives of underprivileged children, their families and communities. Children are the future of a nation. For an emerging country like India, development of underprivileged children holds the key to the progress of nation itself, and their education is a cornerstone for this progress. But education for children cannot be achieved without ensuring the welfare of the family. A child can go to school regularly only when the family, particularly the mother, is healthy and empowered. The family has a decent livelihood opportunity and a steady income. Realizing this, Smile Foundation, beginning in the corridors of education, has adopted a life cycle approach with intensive programs focused on family, health, livelihood and community engagement through women empowerment, which addresses the needs of less privileged children, their families and the larger communities. Let us summarize. In India, social welfare administration is being carried out by a number of governmental and non-governmental organizations. The Social Welfare Administration brings a revolutionary changes, and it has to adapt to the change of the functioning and management of government. In order to achieve the aims and objectives of social welfare, the role of government and non-government helps to promote and to mobilize the total material and human resources so as to improve the quality of life of the vulnerable and weaker sections.